to hang around your neck and really impress the ladies. Don't forget, everyone knows if you can support
the man, smart.
You can support.
Mr. Zoo or Pat Flinger thingy?
Right, I'm on, babe. Whatever you fancy. Fine by me, as long as we talk about animals. I don't give a damn what you call them. As long as it ain't Sheila or something.
You're silly, Mr. Zoo. Why would I call you Sheila?
I don't know, love. You tell me.
Okay, this is getting confusing. It says here your name is Mr. Zoo, and now you're saying your name is Pat Flanagan, and now you're saying it's Sheila?
Yeah, doll, the name ain't Sheila. That's a Sheila's name. It's an Australian joke.
Oh, hey. I don't speak Australian.
Guess not, sweetheart.
Okay, well, moving on. You're Mr. Zoo.
And I am.
Cool. And I hear you made quite a name for yourself. Why is that?
Because I love animals, Aime. Animals and publicity and stuff. But I love animals. Oh, I love them.
Me too!
That's the thing, babe. We all love animals, but we don't know too much about them. That's what I'm here to tell you about. That and myself, of course.
Of course. So, right. What about animals?
Well, it's interesting, right? But not all the folks realize that we're 90% the same as a fly or a cockroach or a pigeon. That's the new science out there called genestics, I think. Which is going to be real popular real soon. But what it tells us is all animals are pretty much the same from a genetic level.
Oh, cool.
Damn right it's cool, babe. You know what that means, don't you?
No, I haven't got a clue.
It means we've all got to start caring for one another like family.
Okay, so let me get this straight. Like, my brother is a cockroach, and my dad is a pigeon, and my mom is a fly. Is that right?
Well, sort of genetically speaking, but you're bang on, love. And you know what that also means?
No.
That you could, legally speaking, marry any animal you wanted to have kids. Unless you're married already, babe. You ain't married, are you?
No, I just split up with my boyfriend. He didn't like me being on the radio. Whatever. I sounded stupid.
Well, that's my point, love. I mean, imagine if you've been out dating a wolf or a kid in a deer. He'd protect you and stuff. You urinate to keep out intruders. But he wouldn't mind you being on the radio. Wouldn't mind a bit.
Why not?
Wolves and deers have no concept of jealousy at someone else's success. That's the genetic variation between Homo erectus and spider monkeys. Jealousy and fear and stuff.
Oh.
Oh, indeed, sweet flies. Oh, indeed. Would you like Mr. Zoo to tell you something else?
Yeah.
Everything you learned in school was a lie, babe. A lie. Take virology, for instance. You were told sharks are dangerous, right?
Yes.
Cobblers, babe. They're frightened of you. They ain't gonna hurt you. Have you ever tried cuddling a shark, getting down and dirty with one, relaxing it a little? Well, I have, and I'll tell you, it's very rewarding, Aime, babe? Very rewarding indeed.
Really?
Yeah, abso-bloody-lutely, love. Once you calm it down with a little rubbing, it's like a swimming puppy. Real affectionate and stuff.
Okay, I'll try that.
You should, love. You really should. Let me tell you something else.
Go on, go on.
Well, this is something for the guys out there, really. You know, with a girl, right, you ain't got a clue. I mean, a female.